I can't even lie. I'm pissed off. I feel like I'm suffocating under a pile of stupidity because some people still believe that this pandemic isn't real. You know what's not real? Cartoons aren't real. Unicorns aren't real. But the people's lives you're putting in danger by not wearing your mask? That's real. The families that can't go see each other? That's real. The stores that are going out of business because you can't put your damn mask on? That's real. Online learning. I wake up, get dressed, and spend 6 full hours in front of a screen. I can't focus. With my sister talking, my parents' meetings, my dog barking, I can't focus. Turn your camera on. Those dreadful words are spoken so easily by the people who aren't under the pressure of high school anymore. Laughter and names are ringing between my ears as my confidence is slowly chipped away piece by piece. The cracking of my voice when I open my mic to say here. Morning voice, right? I chuckle nervously, but deep down I want to zip my mouth shut and throw away the key. Quarantine, an introvert's dream. Yeah, right. Every time I go to school now, everyone is so excited to talk. Meanwhile, I feel myself reverting back to my old ways. The ways that had me constantly sitting in the corner of the room with my music at full volume. The ways I had worked so hard to get out of. The ways that had me bottling up my emotions because I know every time I ever spoke out about them, I lost people I cared about. I don't want to go back to those ways. They scare me. Those ways scare me. Wait, when was the last time I went outside? Did I drink water today? I can't even look at myself anymore. Health is a big thing in my family, yet I didn't seem to get the hint. Every time I look in the mirror, it feels like I'm looking at a completely different person. Everyone is telling me I'm lucky, but my body is telling me I'm ugly, and my mind is telling me I'm worthless. My physical health is getting worse, and my mental health is constantly nagging at me like the clock on the wall during a math test that seems to be ticking as loud as a plane. Anxiety. Anxiety, anxiety. That word is more present in my life than my friends are. You get good grades, why would you be stressed about that? I work hard for my grades, which means I'm used to 80s and 90s. How dare I complain? I shouldn't complain. I'm not allowed to. My grades are perfect. Until they're not. Until I'm not good enough anymore. Until perfect isn't good enough anymore. Suddenly, I can't meet my expectations. Suddenly, I feel like I'm disappointing my family. School is no longer fun. Report cards are the enemy. I feel like I'm drowning. Suddenly, I'm hopeless.
Hi, I'm Sujata Saha. I'm the current principal of Heritage Regional High School in 2021. This is my third year as principal of Heritage.
What is one of the biggest challenges you've had to face at Heritage since COVID-19 has emerged?
Biggest challenges, I think safety is always a priority, but now it consumes a big chunk of our hours every day. Every little thing, such as removing the doors from the bathroom, we have to think of that because too many hands touch the door. You know, getting somebody to sanitize all the stair ramps, the desks, making sure that kids no longer go from class to class and now they have to be stuck in the bubble. So we have to really relook on how to reschedule, restructure our school. I'm lucky because we have a team that works together. We had an actual COVID-19 committee that we struck, and we really brainstormed on what it could look like this year.
How would you say the pandemic has affected the student life?
The student life has been impacted in a great, great way. There's so much good stuff happening in the classes in terms of learning, but any kid can find a place to belong to outside the class, whether it be sports or arts or, you know, leadership or just activities and being part of something. I think that's harder right now because of the restrictions. They're making do with the constraints that they have, but I think there are some kids that they need that live contact with somebody else that's not focus on academics, and that's not happening at this time, unfortunately.
How do you think the staff and teachers at Heritage are coping with the present circumstances?
I think the anxiety is high every day. You just have this added stress, like physically just wearing this all day is not easy. So it's tough, but at the same time, somehow they forget the COVID reality and they teach their history class or their math class or their ethics class, and then they kind of get lost in the passion of their subject.
What is one thing you are most looking forward to once this global pandemic is behind us?
Just being able to see kids smile. Like for me, you know, I just love seeing, yes, you see it in their eyes, but seeing the real smiles right now, seeing them happy, laughing. It is happening, but it's behind a mask. Well, high school is something that marks you for the rest of your life, and you have fun moments inside and outside the school. Trips coming back, I mean, we're a school of so many great trips. You know, sports, games happening, and shows in the auditorium, and and just being able to hug people and really, you know, when they're going through hard times, being able to physically comfort them, I think is a big part that's not happening right now either.
Alors, je suis Martin Labrie, je suis professeur d'art à l'École Héritage, and I'm also a dance teacher since I moved to Heritage, and I teach dance to the kids in sport excellence, ICANN and FAF for the four arts, and regular art from Sec 1 to Sec 4 this year.
So how are teachers coping with the pandemic at the moment?
I try to take it one day at a time. This is what my solution was. I don't try to look at all the news all the time to be like depressed or affected by it. I take care of my family and my friends. And at school, my solution is to take it when there's a new change. I just adapt to it and I try my best to stay positive.
COVID-19 affected your class?
One of the big things is normally I like to do outdoor artwork like in April and May. This year I move it to September, October. We went outside already for Halloween, and I tried to change my setting in my own class. So I'm bringing one class a week in my art room. So most of the time I'm teaching in all the class of the ups of each group I have this year. And for dance it's the same thing. I'm using a bigger space. In Cap D I have a dance floor, but I'm dancing now mostly in the entire class space. And I bring the kids outside for dancing also.
So how do you keep your kids engaged in through all of this and through your art?
One of the things I try to do is to make experience regarding what they do in their out-of-school life. Like when there was a class online, I'm going to give an example. They used what they have in their bedroom to draw or sketch. Or they look at through the window in their bedroom and they take picture, they do photography, they draw an object that they have in their bedroom, their favorite t-shirt, favorite shoes. So I'm trying to adapt to the reality of where they are. I use more their cell phone this year. I use more their laptop and their tablet because they have it at home when they take my class. Dance, it was very interesting because they need to dance in their living room, in their bedroom, in the basement, so they need to set up a little dance floor. So it was interesting for me. I learned a lot from my students. That was the big difference.
And what's one of the things you're most looking forward to in the school once the global pandemic is over?
I think I'm going to keep probably some of the habits that I developed and the new strategy. I'm going to be excited to have the kids back in my class full time, like me using the art room, the sink, the paintbrush, doing bigger projects in the art studio. For dance, I think it's going to be like doing more interaction with the kids, like this. They can do ballroom together, they can do a lift if we do ballet or contemporary dance. That's going to be a big change to go back in this area. But for the rest of it, it's like I try to always see myself as an artist, to use all the difficulties and all the moment of like doubt to create a solution and stay positive and try to bring a new direction to everything I do. So this is it.
Well, thank you so much for your time.
Merci beaucoup, Jessica.
My name is Nancy Turuff. I teach secondary 4 and 5 science at Heritage Regional High School. I'm also the student life coordinator here. We also have a house system, and I'm in charge of that, and I get the help of 8 or 10 very eager students every year.
How do you think COVID-19 has affected your class?
I have very good students that are, for the most part, very involved in their education and want to learn. So for most of my students, I would say that COVID hasn't changed so much for them. For some of them, it definitely is hard for them to learn online. Some of them are more disorganized. And what I'm finding that I'm not doing as well as I used to do or can't do is that I can't see the kids to help them at lunch hour anymore. So if students need help, they call me at night and I'm Zooming at night with them or opening a team chat or something like that. But that's what I feel, that the kids aren't doing as well as they could be because they're not getting the help from the teacher that they want.
Do you prefer teaching in person or online?
Definitely in person. I hate being online. I was so excited for those 2 or 3 weeks where they actually brought us back with everybody here. Seeing a black rectangle with the student's name, and it makes me sad. I don't have that rapport that I normally would have with kids. You can't really see their expression. They can't see me smile. Sure, you can kind of tell by the eyes, but it's definitely not the same thing. I miss the contact.
How do you keep students engaged with all the material you're teaching them during the pandemic?
I'm the type of person who, even if you don't like something, I can be so excited about it that a little bit of my excitement moves on to you. So now my students, sometimes if I'm doing something, go, oh, but Miss, you didn't do a Desmos with us this time. Anyway, so I try to do that. Unfortunately, a lot of what we normally would have done, like the labs in science, we can't do, so we're doing some virtual lab simulations, which isn't the same for the students, definitely. But at least they're seeing a little bit of the theory through a little bit of action or movement, rather than me just being teaching. And that's what I'm finding that I have to do this year too, is where I'm just like, here's the stuff, do the exercises, ask me a question, but like there's no real hands-on. I miss that this year.
What has been the biggest challenge for teachers since COVID has emerged?
I think it's making sure that the students keep engaged. And it's also because we only see them half the time, like I was saying before, I don't feel as close to my classes this year as I normally would with other classes. And particularly for me, because I'm involved with the student life, we haven't done the leadership camps. The way that we're organizing the house activities are totally different. I've got a group of 8 students that work with me, but we meet each other on Zoom. Normally there's a room in the school where we all meet together. We have lunch 3 or 4 times a week together. They really bond, whereas this year my heads of house aren't bonding the way they normally do. So that's what I'm finding really difficult for me.
In one word, how would you describe Heritage Regional High School?
This year, resilience, we're gonna make it.
Thank you so much.
Okay, you're welcome.
Hi, my name is Jasmine. I'm a student council member and I'm in Sec 1.
Hello Jasmine, as a student that is part of the student council, do you feel as if there's enough activities going on at the moment?
No, because of course COVID is kind of taking over.
Are you feeling less motivated to attend classes than before COVID-19?
Yes, because I feel like there's nothing to look up to.
What do you wish to see more of in the school once the pandemic is over?
I hope to see more activities, because of course it would be more fun.
Thank you, Jasmine.
My name is Davico Costner. I'm in Secondary 3.
Hi, D'Amico. Are you feeling less motivated to attend classes than before the pandemic?
Yes, but at the same time, no, because motivation isn't really my problem with this pandemic and stuff. I feel a little uncomfortable being in school during the pandemic, but I'm sure most people have that problem too, because a lot of people don't really want to be in a like school while a pandemic's happening. But for me, it doesn't really affect my motivation too much.
Is wearing a mask affecting your education in any way?
No, wearing a mask is completely fine for me. Maybe for some other people it's hard, but I have no qualms about masks and education.
What's one thing you're most looking forward to in the school once COVID-19 is over?
Sports, for sure. Basketball. I like playing basketball and playing during lunch in the gyms which we can't do anymore. But yeah, for sure, sports.
In one word, how would you describe Heritage Regional High School?
Good. It's a good school.
Hi, I'm Lucas, and I'm in Century.
Hi, Lucas. Do you feel as if virtual learning is more effective than in-person learning?
Personally, it's less effective because while you're like in actual school, the teacher could see you being on your phone, and they'll ask you to stop being on your phone so you can pay attention more. While you're online, the teacher doesn't know what you're doing, your camera's off, you could be on your phone, playing video games, and not paying attention.
How do you think your teachers are coping with everything going on at the moment?
Well, considering this virus came out of nowhere, this could have been like a sudden switch, so that I don't think any teacher has done this ever before, online learning, so it's kind of harder to like do work, send in work at the same time, because some of them don't know how it really works.
In one word, how would you describe Heritage Regional High School?
James
Hi, James. What's one of your biggest challenges since the pandemic has set foot in your lives?
Honestly, the biggest challenge I'd say is the fear of other people. I'm constantly scared that something may happen and may catch it, or I may spread it on.
Do you feel as if Heritage took the right precautions to ensure everyone's safety?
I honestly think I have, and I think that the situation we're in now is less their fault, that they've been doing the best they can with the new situation that's been uprising.
Do you feel as if virtual learning is more effective than in-person learning?
And I can honestly say that it's not. I do not suffer from ADHD or any other condition that can inhibit my learning, but I know a lot of other people who do, and it can be much more difficult for those.
Mm-hmm. Are you feeling less motivated to attend classes than before the pandemic?
No, I feel even more motivated. I feel that my education is even more in my hands, and I have more control over my future.
How do you think your teachers are coping with everything going on at the moment?
I have no idea, but I hope they're doing well. They're doing their absolute best they can given the circumstances.
In one word, how would you describe Heritage Regional High School?
Try.
The edge, you were sitting there. Hold the rope and we'll go up, up, up. But I'll fly a little higher. Go up in the clouds because the view's a little nicer up here. My dear, it won't be long now. It won't be long now. When we get back on the land, well, I'll never get my chance. Be ready to live. Right out of my hands, and maybe someday we'll take a little ride. We'll go up, 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 and everything will be just fine. We'll go up, 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 but I'll fly a little higher. Go up in the clouds because the view's a little nicer up here, my dear. Only I had a little bit more time. If only I had a little bit more time with you. We could go up, up, up and take that little ride. We'll sit there holding hands and everything will be just right. Maybe someday I'll see you again. We'll float up in the clouds and we'll never see the end. We'll go up, 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 but I'll fly a little higher. Go up in the clouds because the view's a little nicer. I'll hear my dear.
What a glorious field and I'm happy. I'm laughing at the clouds, so dark up above. The sun's in my heart, and I'm ready for love. Let the stormy clouds chase everyone from the plane. Come on with the rain, I will smile on my face. I walk down the lane with a happy refrain, just singing in the rain. I'm happy again.